Doom, doom, doom. You're waking up at 9 o'clock. Do Miss Ponce, Jiggets, and Lashard. But don't you feel bad. Here comes a guy named Conrad, and he is gonna start the nine at nine. Whoa, it's the nine at nine. Whoa, it's the nine at nine.
Nice.
All right, number nine, there is a pretty good chance you weigh more in Illinois than you do in Indiana. It's a phenomenon known as uneven gravity.
Huh.
Or the Illinois diet. Take a look at this map and the gravity anomalies across three Midwestern states. You'll notice lots of red spots here in Illinois. That means our state has more gravity than average.
Huh.
You'll see lots of blue spots in Indiana and Ohio. That means those states have less gravity than average. We know what you're saying, Pat, why is that? Well, it's complicated, so you'd have to Google it. All you need to know is this. The less gravity in your state, the less you weigh.
So how many pounds do I lose by crossing the border? That's important to me.
A lot.
Yeah.
I mean, is it a pound?
The thing is, you got to stay there forever and you can never come back.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Give it a try. Let's see what happens. You can call us and let us know.
So does that mean I'm more attractive in Indiana than
I am in Illinois? No,
That's a great segment. We could go down to the state line, have a scale on both sides of the line, and then just weigh various people.
We'll drive you to various spots. Rensselaer, Crown Point. Yeah.
So that means like an Illinois 8 is an Indiana 10?
Maybe.
Yeah.
Something like that?
Yeah.
I mean,
you said it, and thankfully none of us.
Yeah. Why am I not?
Yeah,
I could be really hitting it out of the park in Indiana.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
Well, wow.
We get that van going over there.
All right.
Big time. All right, number eight. I just posted this recipe on my easy home cooking / guilt-free snacking blog. It only took me 2 seconds. You know why? Because there are only two ingredients in this treat. These are chocolate banana ice cream bites, and they're delicious. But there's not really any ice cream. You take some bananas that are just a little bit overripe, and you're going to cut them up, and you're going to put them in the freezer. Then blend them up for a couple of minutes, and then you add some chocolate chips to that creamy mix, and then put them in little mini muffin pans.
Ooh.
And in about an hour, you're gonna have that delicious treat that tastes exactly like banana chocolate chip ice cream.
Isn't that fun? That looks actually pretty good.
Yeah, check out my blog.
Number seven, Swifties can't get enough of Travis Kelce, especially after seeing her at the game again last night. But here's something else you might not know about Travis. His favorite pregame meal, French toast.
Oh.
We're not sure if it's a tradition or superstition, but he says he's eaten French toast before every preseason, regular season, playoff, and Super Bowl game. And he's reportedly been doing this ever since becoming a Kansas City Chief in 2013.
See, and that's an athlete, carbs.
Yep.
So what do you guys say about that?
I'm an athlete.
He's an athlete.
Yeah.
When you're burning 8,000 calories a day, you can eat all the French toast you want.
Yeah.
You're not burning 8,000 calories a day.
You don't know my life.
In a week.
No. I'm very busy when I leave here. You don't know. All right, number six. This jacket answers the question, where am I going to put all this beer? This is called the Sixer Insulated Jacket. This one is a limited edition PBR version. It's made by the clothing company called 686. There's a bunch of insulated pockets for carrying cans of beer. They can go in the front pockets, chest pocket, pocket inside. Wherever you are this winter, you'll be able to drink a can of beer. And, you know, it's going to make you look a little bulkier than you might like, but better than carrying a cooler.
Right, yeah. And at some point, you may want to start thinking, do I have any problems?
Do I have a problem?
I just bought six of these coats.
Do I have a problem that I need a beer with me at a moment's notice?
Yeah, I think I'm all right. Because you can get them at the grocery store. You can keep them in your refrigerator. We're a car's drive away from, who knows.
And number five, let's talk about fairy circles. According to a new study, fairy circles have been identified at hundreds of new sites around the world, which proves they're more widespread than previously thought.
Yeah.
Here's what we know about fairy circles. The mysterious patches that appear in the middle of landscapes usually are in Africa and Australia, and they almost always occur in similar situations, places with soil that has low nitrogen and in areas with low rainfall. The recent study used satellite images to discover 260 new fairy circle sites in 15 different countries, which is exciting news in the world of fairy circles. Read more about it in Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences.
All right.
All right, number four, the holidays are coming up. So how about this for the person who's got everything? The 1945 Nobel Prize for the discovery of penicillin. Actual Nobel Prize.
What?
That's nice.
It was awarded to Dr. Ernst Chain, and it can be yours for just under $2 million.
Yeah, that's a little pricey.
Because it's going on the auction block. Check out RaoAntiques.com for details. It's a 23-karat gold medal and comes in its original box that'll be sure to impress the people at book club or when your pals come over for game night. In case you're wondering, penicillin has saved at least 200 million lives since its introduction back in 1944.
Wow. Doesn't make you wonder why no one in his family thought, maybe I'll hang on to that or give it, I don't know. That you wonder what happened there.
Maybe they were a little hard-pressed with
some needed
cash,
some cash.
You know,
Or maybe they didn't
Maybe he didn't like his family.
Yeah, they were like, let's get out of here.
All right, number three, there's hope for guys who aren't all that hot. A study out of Florida State University has found that women are happier when their partners are less attractive than they are.
Yeah,
the guys feel so lucky to be with a good-looking girl that they're more likely to do whatever it takes to keep her, and that means getting her presents, helping out around the house, keeping her happy. On the flip side, typically handsome guys may think the grass is greener somewhere else and can be less committed to their relationships.
Yeah, listen, us sexy men are just as lazy as the next guy. We're happy with what we got, and we know we're sexy, and that's enough for us.
Yeah. All right.
We're content. All right, number two. This right here is the heavy-duty brush cutter. It is, of course.
What the heck?
Is awesome. This is from the good folks.
Wow.
Pro attachments. Look at that. Family-owned business. They make all kinds of heavy-duty equipment in a factory in Minnesota. Isn't that something? Wouldn't it be fun to drive that around?
Yeah.
Get out to Bussy Woods, clear that out.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's tremendous. Wow.
That is
satisfying.
It sure is.
Yeah. Isn't that cool?
Look at that.
Attachments make all the difference on your.
Yeah. All right, number one, here's a cool looking Halloween costume. Actually, no, this is a real animal.
What?
No.
No other creature looks more like a human in dress-up than the Shoebill stork.
Wow.
It lives in tropical East Africa in large swamps from Sudan to Zambia.
How big
is this
fellow?
Well, I'm going to tell you right now, the big ones, Paul, can be up to 4 feet tall.
Shut the front door.
And the Shoebill is carnivorous. It's generally seen either walking slowly through a marsh as it hunts or standing motionless.
Oh, it looks like it's hunting.
In the water.
Oh.
Also, guess what? They fly.
Come on.
Yeah. But usually no farther than about 60 feet, but still they can fly.
What the heck?
I've never seen that in my life. That is terrifying.
Wait a minute, they're carnivorous? It'd take a bite right out of her hand.
Yeah. I want to see it hunt. Ooh, and they can dance.
That's the really cool thing about them.
Let's bring one of those over here. A couple of them over here.
That is amazing.
You got 50 of those, and you teach them how to like play instruments or something, you got a pretty good halftime show at the Bears game.
Yeah.
Wow.
Your Shoebill.
If they're expensive, it'd be fun to own. Have that wandering around your house.
Yeah.
I wonder if we could teach a few to write news scripts, too.
Yeah.
Well, that was a great 9 at 9.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Thank you. It's a 9 at 9.